Alright guys, so this lawnmower doesn't have a fuel tank, doesn't have a starter, doesn't have a starter solenoid, doesn't have a key switch, and doesn't have a battery. I also need to put some connectors on here, so we'll do that. Alright, so we got our new key switch. Got to feed this wire through here. Boom. All right, so next thing is the fuel tank. That fits on there perfect. I'm gonna have to find some bolts to screw in there and connect this fuel line. But before I put that on, I'm gonna take this whole, let me bring the camera over here. All right, so I'm gonna take this whole fuel line, fuel filter, carburetor apart because we're definitely probably gonna be having some carburetor issues. I'm just gonna drop the bowl and show you that. And then I'm just gonna clean this whole fuel system out because no telling what's in there. So that's pretty snug. There we go, look at that. I might take this cover off and clean the magnets on the flywheel and check the coil. For a bit of fun, let's just pull the spark plug out and see what kind of condition it's in. All right, come on now, break loose. See, look, this is what frustrates me. It's like, I'm trying to get it off. See, look, it won't go in right here. But, you know, it'll go in kind of right there. Oh, look, it's actually loosening. But it only goes over that much. And it's loose enough for this, but it's tight enough to where you can't get your hands in there to manually unthread it. Hoping this engine is going to run. If it doesn't run, we got an 18-horse V-twin brig so we can put on here. So let's just spin this engine over real quick. What the crap? Is that water? Yeah, if we got water in here, we got a little bit of a problem. All right, so I just sprayed a little bit of brake cleaner directly in the cylinder, spun it over, and that's what came out. All right, so let's take a little break from that, and let's throw the solenoid in. All right, guys, so when I got this battery, I checked the voltage, and it was 11.7. So I stuck it on this charger for a little while on 10 amps. Just to get a bit more juice in it. And this lawnmower over here, since I don't have a wire going from the starter to the solenoid, I'm just gonna hook jumper cables directly on the starter and see if this engine is gonna spin over. Also, I did spray a PB Blaster in the cylinder, let it sit overnight. And you know, it can't do it one-handed, but you know, it spins over pretty good. Doesn't sound like it's knocking or anything like that. Before I start this engine, I'm gonna check the valve flasher on here. Also, y'all, another thing worth considering is that we probably could have a stuck valve in this engine, and I don't even know it. But when I did spin it over by hand with the spark plug in it, it seems like it felt like it had good compression. So I don't really think it could be a stuck valve, but we're ripping this off. Let's have a little look anyway. Ooh. All right, I don't want to break this gasket on this thing. I want to try to reuse this gasket. Yeah, that gasket's kind of trashed. I might have to order a new one, but with this being a budget engine, we're gonna try to reuse it. If it leaks oil like crazy, duh, I'm gonna have to buy a new one, but for right now, we're gonna reuse it. You can see that, it's just sludge. I think that's just typical engine sludge. All right, so the piston's at top dead center. That is a lot of play in there. Now, you don't want it so tight to where it can't move. You just want just enough where it's a decent bit of drag, like that, and just hold your wrench and tighten it up. So yeah, there you go. Valve flash should be done. Now you're supposed to check it again when it's hot, but you know, don't really care about that. As long as it's set, kind of okay. That's all that pretty much matters. This here is about an hour, 45 minutes to an hour worth of wasteful footage that's not worth uploading in here. Just trying to start it for a while, but it didn't work, so let's cut to this now.
Alright guys, so I just took the fan shroud off. I kind of polished this up a little bit with the drill right there. Put that battery
on charge, let it sit there and charge for a little while. So let's see if it has plenty of juice to spin this thing over. Mainly y'all, I just want to spray starting fluid in the carburetor, try to start it, see if it'll run on starting fluid, and then cut it off. So that way I know the engine actually runs, and then we can proceed in the fuel system, because there's no point redoing absolutely everything and the engine's junk.
Wow. Okay. By the way, these are some bullcrap jumper cables that are from the back of my truck. So they're not very good at conducting electricity. All right, so now I got some real jumper cables. Strong enough to probably jump a semi off because those other bullcrap jumper cables probably won't even start the Nitro Rustler up or the RC car because they're so weak. So spray a bit more ether in it real quick and just pop it off and see if it's gonna start. Boom, it runs. That's all I need to know.
So yeah, I think it's worth continuing on this build and turning it into something really epic. And y'all, that does show that jumper cables actually do make a difference, because you might think it's the battery and all that, but in theory, it could just be you got crappy jumper cables. So that's another thing to check. Now let's real quick take this carburetor apart and clean it out good. The throttle doesn't really work because that whole throttle system is all seized up. All right, so I just got the carburetor off there. I got all the intake parts up there, kind of cleaned them out good. So now let's look on the inside of this carburetor. Focus. Since I got it off, I got these screws loose now. So we're gonna take these things out of here and see what this bowl looks like. I'm guessing there's gonna be a lot of corrosion. Yeah, ooh. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna clean that out. Looks really nasty. Float seems to be okay. Ooh, there's some kind of sticky stuff right here, so this is very bad. All right, so I'm gonna clean this whole carburetor off camera because this will be way too much to film. All right, so I just got the carburetor kind of halfway apart and I stuck it in this bucket here and kind of filled it up with gas just to let it kind of soak a little bit. I'll go in there with the toothbrush or whatever and kind of scrub excess out, because literally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wow, 5 cans of carburetor cleaner. You know, I was sitting here and this one was almost empty. And all of them are almost empty. And I can only spray a little bit and they're all gone. And this one still had like a little bit more left. So this is the only can that actually has a relatively okay amount in it. All right, so I just got this thing rebuilt. Looks pretty good-ish. Was pretty easy. So let's now throw this thing back on. So happens here on this parts bin, I have a fuel cutoff valve and a new fuel filter. So that's perfect. Got the fuel tank on there, got the fuel line on there, got the fuel cutoff there, fuel filter there, and rest of the fuel line there, rebuilt whole air and fuel system. So all I gotta do now is pretty much add some gas to it. Hopefully there's no leaks and start it up. Gonna run longer than 2 seconds. All right, so clearly we're not getting any fuel. I'm gonna pull the choke out a little bit more. so we're having some carburetor issues as expected.
Hold on a sec. Never mind, the choke was off. I was turning it off, so I turned it on full choke now. I don't know about half throttle. Let's see what happens now.
Yes, guys, I'm so happy this thing actually runs. Like, I'm so excited about this now. Like before, look at all the stuff that came out of there. The kill switch hadn't hooked up, so I had to cut it off by using the choke, which I didn't really want to die, but it finally died. But yeah, you know, it seems to respond very well. If you want to know why these fans are on, it's because the fan shroud was off and I don't want to sit there. I don't want the engine sitting there idling and just overheating. So I have a fan blowing on it right there and a fan just kind of halfway blowing on it right there. And now I know that it actually runs, I'm going to change the oil in it, which is why I didn't really run it very, very long. Because no telling what that oil has in it. It looked kind of okay, but I don't really trust it. I need to really hook up all the wiring. I need to actually hook the switch up and all that stuff so the kill switch and all that stuff works, because this switch doesn't really do anything, which is why I used the choke in order to cut it off. Steering, a bit sketchy, but you know, it works, so we're not really gonna mess with that right now. You put the fan shroud back on. New tires, obviously. Might turn this into a handbrake, I don't know, we'll see. But, yeah, so far it's going to plan, so I'm really excited about this. That's a Duramax outside if you hear that. So yeah, I hope you liked this video. If you did, click all the buttons that YouTubers say to click. If you didn't like this video, click on thumbs down twice. And y'all should see me in the next one.